Hello students, welcome back to the SST classroom. Now student, in the last video, we started our chapter, right? That is lesson number 21, the Constitution of India, right? So student, in the last video, we have only discussed the introduction of the lesson, right? In that, we have learned about the Constitution of India. So, my dear student, what is the constitution? As you all know, every country has a constitution, right? So, it is a set of rules according to which the government governs the country. This set of rules which help the government to govern the country is called constitution. So, my dear student, what is constitution? Means a set of rules which help the government to govern the country is called constitution. And student, do you know the Constitution of India is the longest written constitution in the world? Okay students, I hope you have understood the introduction of the Constitution of India. So, my dear students, can you tell me when the constitution came into force, on which date? That is on 26 January 1950. Okay. Now let's learn the second concept, that is the preamble to our constitution. Okay, students. Now, students, just see the page. The image which is given on your screen, this is the preamble to our constitution. So preamble, you can say introduction. This is the introduction to the constitution, in which it is written that India is a sovereign, socialist, democratic, secular and republic country. Okay student, now let's see what is the exact meaning of preamble. Okay. So, preamble means the brief introduction to the Constitution of India is known as preamble. It is a brief introduction to the Constitution. Now, students, to know better, I will give you one example about your textbook. You might be having your textbook, right? English textbook, SST textbook, Hindi textbook. So in front, first page, you see the index page, right? And in that, what is written? It is written the topic, or you can say the lesson. What is there in this book? Okay. So preamble is also same like that. It is an introduction to the Constitution of India. Okay. I hope you have understood about the preamble. Now, my dear students, so what is the purpose of the preamble? It is the set of goals that we need to achieve for making India a better nation. Okay. Now, my dear children, now next we are going to see the important terms which are used in the preamble. So, students, there are 5 important terms which are used in the preamble. So that is, the first is sovereign, second is socialist, third is secular, fourth is democratic and fifth republic. So student, one by one we are going to understand about these 5 important terms which are used in preamble. So let's start with the first one, that is sovereign. What does this sovereign means? It means that India cannot be governed by any other power apart from the government of India. Means India will not be ruled by any other power. Only the government of India can rule. There will be no rule of king rule, etc. Okay? Apart from the government of India, only the government of India can rule. that is about the sovereign. Now, let's see the second one, that is socialist. It means that all people are equal and will be treated as equal. Means everyone are equal in the eyes of law. Nobody will be discriminated. Everyone will get equal right in the constitution. Okay. Now let's see the third one, that is secular. Now what does this secular mean? It means that all people are free to practice any religion. Student, you know that India is the home to the people of different languages, culture, religion, etc. Okay, so people can follow any religion of their choice. So that is about the secular. People are free to choose their religion. So this we talk about the secular. Now let's discuss about the fourth one, that is democratic. Now what does this democratic means? It means that the people have right to choose their own government. Means the people are free to choose their own government. Now students, a reading of preamble makes it clear that the Indian citizen have right to vote and elect their representatives to form the government. Means people can choose the representatives to form the government. So this system of governance is called democracy. No discrimination is to be made between the rich and the poor. All the people are equal in the eyes of the law. Okay, student. So this is known as the rule of law. The Indian citizen also have the liberty of thought and expression. So student, the people having the right to choose their own government by doing the fair election. Okay. I hope you have understood about the democratic. Now let's move to the fifth one, that is republic. It means that the country has no monarch to rule over it. Okay student, you know what is the meaning of monarch? Means the king rule. You might be have learned the story of many king, right? Or you might be have heard about the king rule, right? In olden times, there were the king rule, who used to rule the state, who used to rule the region, etc. But after independence, there is no monarch to rule over it. The people choose their own leaders who form government and run the countries. Okay, students, I hope you have understood about the republic. So these are the five terms which are use in preamble. So that is the first one, sovereign. Second, socialist. Third, secular. Fourth, democratic. Fifth, republic. Okay students, I hope you have understood about all these five concepts, all these five terms. So student, today you are going to read the textbook thoroughly and write new words in your notebook. Now take down your new words which is there on your screen. So the first one is sovereign. Second, socialist. Third, sovereign. Sorry, both are same. Students, take down your new words. First, sovereign. Second, socialist. Third new words, secular. Fourth, democratic.
Fifth, Republic. Sixth, Representative. Seventh, Liberty. And eighth one, Equality. Okay, student. So these all new words you will write in your notebook and you will learn also. Okay. Thank you. Have a nice day.